Hey guys, LQ here with the LQ Review, back with my Survivor review for this week. This is Survivor Season 38, Edge of Extinction, Episode 5. So we are now 5 episodes in, but this episode was a 2-hour episode. So 2 people went home this episode, so we've now lost 6 people. 6 people have gone to the Edge of Extinction. So let's talk about the stuff that I liked. Let's talk about the stuff that I didn't like. So first, we're going to talk about the stuff that I liked. And the number one thing that I liked that we just have to celebrate, Wendy is gone. Wendy is gone. The waste of a player, the waste of a spot, the waste that was Wendy is now at the edge of extinction. I was hoping that she was going to take that torch and just leave. She's a waste of a spot. She's a waste of a player. She has no strategic sense, no challenge skills, no social awareness. She's a waste. How she made it this far perplexes me. Just utterly perplexes me. If she gets back in this game, I'll be so annoyed. Because I despise Wendy. Despise her. So it's good that she's gone. That lists under my good. Last week, Wendy was listed under my bad because she was still alive. But she's voted out. That's a good thing. So, Wendy, see ya. Let's see. You know what? Last week, I also had Extinction Island, or Edge of Extinction. I had that under my bad. I came around to it a little bit this week. I won't say I'm fully on board with it, but I at least was like, okay. Okay, I'm getting this. I'm seeing where you're going, and this isn't all bad. So, giving them ways to influence the game from the outside and keeping it anonymous, I like that. I like that. It adds a whole new dimension to the game. Now, Aubrey wasted it, but it really adds a neat dimension to the game. And it looks like somebody's going to get back in the game next week. So the question is somebody going to get back in the game and then the rest are going to leave the game for good? Or is somebody going to get back in the game and then everybody else is just going to stay on Edge of Extinction while they're waiting for another chance to get back in the game? So that's the question. But this was the first week where I looked at Edge of Extinction and I was like, okay, this has some promise. You know, I actually rooted for Keith a little bit when he went out on his own saying, this is for my family, this isn't for Chris, this isn't for so... I was like, okay, you're playing. So I got that, and I was down with that. So I can't say that I'm like 100% on board with the whole concept of Edge of Extinction, but this was this week was a big turnaround from last week, where last week I was like, this is stupid, I'm bored of it. So this week, it at least has some life in me, there's some optimism in me for it. Victoria is turning into a power player, and I like power players. I'm not one of those guys who's like, I hate villains. I hate people who backstab. I don't care about that. I loved Russell Hance. I loved Richard Hatch. I loved Boston Rob. I love people who are out there to play the game. I love people who are out there to become power players. I don't care how they achieve that means. Play the game. Be a power player. And she is stepping into that. You know, I see a little bit of Parvati in her. Parvati was a power player. I see a little bit of that going on here. Maybe not quite as experienced. Maybe not quite as seasoned. Maybe doesn't quite have the social skills that Parvati did. But there's definitely shades of Parvati in this redhead who's trying to take control of this game. So I appreciate that. And I want to see her continue to develop her skills and make it deep into this game. Speaking of making it deep into this game, Mad Dog probably won't. I don't see Mad Dog making it deep in this game. He's too forward. He telegraphs his moves. Mad Dog telegraphs his moves. So I appreciate the fact that he's playing hard. And he's under my good for this episode. Mad Dog is an active player. He's trying to make things happen. Is he the best at it? Probably not. Is he the best at challenges? No. He's trying to make things happen for him, and I appreciate that, and I'm rooting for him. And he's fun to watch. All right, another good component. Lauren and Wentworth. The kind of this power duo of Lauren and Wentworth that I don't think anybody even are aware that we're looking at a power duo here. But we definitely have this strong pair in Lauren and Wentworth, where not only are they entertaining, but I believe that there's also a lot of skill there. And now that we've got the merge coming next week, I think that we're going to be able to see this skill really blossom, because they both are, I believe both could be very good social players, and both are, you know, I think fairly strong in the challenges. Wentworth was one of my two picks to go all the way. And I think that Lauren can make it very deep as well. And I still believe that. I still believe that Wentworth could go all the way, because now that the merge is happening, she is a strong challenge. She's a strong competitor. She's got very good social skills. So I believe that she can work her way into a group that will give her an advantage and help her go all the way. But we'll see. Some of the bad. Idols everywhere, and nobody wanting to use them. How many idols are in play now? Aubrey probably lost hers. We got Lauren, we got Dave, Wentworth has one. Yeah, so there's a lot of idols in play. Aubrey had one, but she got voted out holding her idol. So idols everywhere, nobody wants to use them, and it'll be nice when they do come into play, because that'll add that component to the game where it could make for some very exciting tribal councils. But right now, it's like I'm sitting on that present. It's like it's Christmas morning, and I'm sitting there, and I'm a kid, and I'm sitting there on Christmas morning, and my parents are making their coffee, and my parents are getting dressed, and my parents, hold on, don't open presents yet, son. And I'm just sitting there, waiting to open my presents, and that's kind of where I'm at with these idols. We got lots of idols, but nobody's wanting to play them. Nobody's wanting to open their present. So, I don't know. So I hate it when people get voted out with idols in their pocket. If there's ever so much as a doubt in your mind, play that idol. Play it. And Aubrey had to have had doubts. She had to, because she even said herself she wasn't sure what position this tribe stood in, where this tribe was standing. So she had to have known that there was a chance that they would have voted for her. So, that being said, speaking of bad, Aubrey. Aubrey falls under the bad category. You know, I thought that she had a good chance at making it far this season, and it just doesn't seem like that's going to happen. I like returning players. I like seasons where returning players come back. I think they add a lot to a season. I always get annoyed when newbies want to take out the returning players just because they're returning players. But that's the reality of the game. So it is what it is. I didn't care for Aubrey's gameplay, and I think this is the weakest of her three showings. Dave, speaking of weak, how was Dave a returning player? How was Dave a returning player? I don't think anybody cares about Dave. And I don't know. It just seems obvious to me as I'm watching the game that he doesn't have a whole lot of skill. How he's made it this far? Honestly, I think he's made it this far just based on the fact that he is a returning player. Because he hasn't brought much to the tribe. I like his story. I like, you know, I appreciate how he said, I'm 44. You know, I'm not married. I live in a two-bedroom apartment. I appreciate that. I appreciate his story, and I appreciate his metamorphosis into a more active life, into being a more active participant in his own life. I appreciate all that. I just don't find him very entertaining. He's not my cup of tea. So maybe he's yours, and that's fine. Just doesn't work for me. So this episode was a big step up from last episode. Last episode, I came away thinking that they needed to do something quick to turn things around. I don't know that this episode was a full, complete turnaround, but I'm feeling a lot better about it. Thank you so much for being here at the OQ Review, where we talk about all the nerdy, geeky stuff that we love to talk about. And until next time, thanks again for being here.